Now these redox reactions are the displacement reaction. That means the more reactive metal displaces the less reactive metal. What is mean by displacement? If there is a salt solution of somewhat less reactive elements, such as copper sulfate is there, copper sulfate solution is there in a container suppose, and if we dip a zinc rod into that copper sulfate solution, zinc is the most reactive element, remember that, than the copper, then how we can see that say that the zinc is more reactive? Now this is from the electromotive force series. In that electromotive force series, what is there? The more reactive elements are below the hydrogen, their electrode potential are there, and hydrogen is in the middle, and the less reactive elements are above the hydrogen. Then from that series, EMF series, electromotive force series, we can say that the elements which are upper the hydrogen are less reactive than the elements which are below the hydrogen. And if we dip the rod of the lower elements in the solution, salt solutions of the upper solution, what happens? That reactive element displaces the less reactive element from the solution. After some time you see, if you dip the zinc rod or zinc plate into the copper sulfate solution, you know that the copper sulfate solution are blue in color. You know that copper sulfate is also called as the blue vitriol. In Marathi it is called as morchur. That is the it have the bluish color. And if we dip the zinc rod into that bluish colored solution, that is of copper sulfate, after some time what happens? The blue color of copper sulfate disappears, vanish. There is no blue color in the solution now. And the zinc rod becomes somewhat reddish in color. That means the copper metal which is present into the copper sulfate get deposited on the zinc rod. Copper is reddish in color. Copper metal have the red color. And due to that, as copper from that copper sulfate solution deposited on that zinc rod, the color of the solution vanish or disappear. It becomes colorless because the zinc metal goes into that solution and it replaces the copper from that. That means zinc takes place of copper. Zinc ion takes place the place of copper. And that solution, if you taste that solution is not now copper sulfate, but it is now zinc sulfate solution. Because zinc is more reactive element, so it goes into the solution and it displaces the copper from that solution. Do you understand that? Now, these such reactions are called as the displacement reactions. Now, here in the Daniell cell, see on the blackboard. What is there? This is the Daniell cell. And if we do the redox reaction, then there is generation of electricity. Remember that. Now, in place of this voltmeter, if I connect the bulb, then that bulb gets lighter. That means it gets lightening. That means there is formation of electricity, electron flows are there. And so this voltmeter, if we connect these wires and if we on the switch, the voltmeter shows the deviation, deflection. That means there is formation of current, because voltmeter, what is the use of voltmeter? It measures the current. You know in the physics, voltmeter is used for the measurement of current. Now see here, there are the two containers. They may be of glass or plastic containers. See here, in the first container, there is the zinc salt solution. And the same metal rod, that is the zinc electrode, is dipped into this zinc salt solution. Suppose it is zinc sulfate solution. Zinc salt means zinc sulfate solution. Into that, zinc rod is dipped here. And the another container in which there is the copper sulfate solution, suppose, that is the copper salt solution means copper sulfate solution. And into that, the copper rod is dipped, that is copper electrode, that is cathode. Now, anode, this zinc act as the anode and this copper act as the cathode. There is the always. Now, see here, when this zinc dip into this zinc sulfate solution, it gets ionized, the rod. The rod have the zinc atoms and the atoms of zinc get ionized in this way. Zinc solid, this is the zinc solid, that is the zinc rod, and when we dip the zinc rod into this solution, what happens? Zinc ions are formed there, and the zinc atom give two electrons because it is very reactive element, and these two electrons get flow through these wires up to this copper rod, that is the cathode. And what happened? Now, there are the electrons on these copper rods are there. And due to, there are in the solution, what are there? There are the copper ions, because copper sulfate solution. So, copper sulfate solution contains Cu plus 2 ion and SO4 minus minus ion. Now, the Cu plus 2 ions which are present into this copper sulfate solution, take that two electrons. It goes to this, the copper ions go to this electrode, and the copper ions take the electrons which are carried by this wire. And so many copper ions are there around the zinc rod, because they are the negative charge on the zinc rod, and due to that, the copper ions goes to the zinc rod and take the two electrons which are carried by this wire from this electron given by the zinc rod. And these two electrons, this copper take, copper ion sorry, take, and it get neutralized, and the ions are converted into the copper atoms. Now, the ions in the copper sulfate solution, Cu plus 2 ion, deposited on this copper electrode, and the copper electrodes, that is breadth, increases, because already it is of copper and again copper atoms come on that. So if we scratch the copper electrode, copper will be obtained now in this way. Now you know that the donation of electron is oxidation. Now here oxidation is in this half shell, there is oxidation reaction, and gain of electron is reduction. So in this half shell there is the reduction. So this is the redox reaction, because oxidation and reduction takes place simultaneously. That means simultaneously. So this is the redox reaction, and this is the displacement reaction. How it is displacement reaction? See here. Now see here, this is the reaction. Now see, this is the net reaction of the addition of these two. How addition of, if we add this into this, suppose, see here, this reaction, add here, Cu2 plus aqueous plus 2 electron minus gives Cu solid. Okay. Then add these two reaction. What happened? Electron, electron both side get cancelled. Then what is remaining? Zinc solid plus Cu2 plus aqueous. Now this arrow, write down the left hand side, that is the entities to the left hand side, and right hand side entities to the right hand side. Now here is the zinc 2 plus aqueous plus Cu solid. Now see, this is the that reaction. That means these are the two half reaction. When these two half reaction get added, there is the net reaction, and that net reaction is called as the redox reaction. Here what happened in the redox reaction? Now this zinc rod, which is zinc in the atomic form here, lose of 2 electron. It get lost the 2 electron here as shown, and form the Zn2 plus ion. As 2 electrons are given, so it have the plus 2 charge on that. Now this zinc solid is converted into zinc ion. So after some time, this zinc rod becomes less and less, because the zinc, that is metal, which are in the atomic form, goes in the form of ions in the solution. And so the zinc rod after some time becomes decreases and decreases. But what happened here? After some time, what happened here? These, that is the breadth, or the, that is, its breadth increases. That means the rod do not decrease, but it increases. Because why? Because the copper ions which are in the solution get deposited. Here is exactly opposite reaction is formed. Here zinc metal ion, zinc metal atoms goes into the solution as the ion, and here the ions from the solution deposited on the copper rod. Do you understand that? Now in this way, what happened here? Now these copper ions which are present into the solution, Cu plus 2 ion, gain 2 electron which are given by this zinc, and it deposited as the copper metal in the solid form, atomic form. What this reaction shows? This reaction shows that this zinc is very reactive metal than the copper. So zinc displaces copper from the copper sulfate solution. So displacement reactions are nothing but they are the redox reaction, and due to the very spontaneous redox reaction, there is generation of electricity. The electron flow. Now these here, why it is cathode? Because the cations deposited on that. And why it is the anode? Because there are the electrons. Due to giving this electron on the rod, the zinc ion goes into the solution. Two electrons are given by the each and every zinc atom, and there is the negative charge. And what happened here? See here, on rod there is the negative charge, but to the outer side there are the positive charge of copper ions. That means electrical double layer is formed. What means? On the rod there is negative charge due to the carrying electrons there, and in the solution near to that there is the positive copper plus ion. Okay. Now such electrical double layer must be formed, then and then there is formation of electricity. What is here? Here is exactly opposite. Now the rod have the positive zinc plus ions on that, and in solution there is the negative, that is 2 electrons are given by this zinc plus ion. So the solution contain the negative charge, and here also the electrical double layer is formed, and therefore it is called as the anode, anions, cathode, cations due to that. And in this way, the element which is more reactive, it is called as the anode, and the element which is less reactive, it is called as the cathode, when they connect separately. Now what is this? This is the salt bridge. Now what is the function of this salt bridge? Salt bridge is nothing but it is the inverted U-shaped tube. Inverted means inverted. shaped tube which contain the agar agar gel. What is mean by agar agar? It is one type of sea algae. Samudrache shaiva. Algae, sea algae. It is also used in ice creams also. It is the edible algae. And these algae are so, that is, it forms the gel. And into that gel, what is there? It is the U-shaped glass tube containing a gel of KCl, potassium chloride, and NH4Cl, ammonium nitrate, mixed into that gel. Why it is used? Because it we have to invert it. And due to the gel, the solution do not comes out. And what is the function of the side bridge? This only connect these two solutions. And there is the that is flow of ions through that. But the solution comes, do not comes outside, because here is the quad, that there is the glass wool plug. Glass wool plug is there. And due to that, the solution or the gel inside this KCl and agar agar gel inside this U-shaped tube, salt bridge, do not come out. This only connect this two. There are two priorities. If we do not have to use the salt bridge, what we have to use then? Then take a small container of zinc sulfate solution, dipping the zinc rod, and place it into the large container of this copper sulfate solution. But the small, that is the container, must have porous. But due to that, what happened? There may be somewhat solution may be mixed. And therefore, this is the best way to connect this solution by the salt bridge. Now, in construction, you have to write the two separate containers containing zinc and copper salt solution. Zinc rod and copper rod are dipped into them respectively. That means in zinc sulfate solution, zinc rod, and in copper sulfate solution, copper rod. And they are connected by the wire through a switch. Here is switch also to that is on or to off of the voltmeter. There is the switch, and due to that, through the switch and voltmeter, these two electric wires are connected. The two solutions are connected by a side bridge, which is the inverted U-shaped tube containing a gel of KCl and NH4NO3 in agar agar. And how this cell works? Now, when the switch is on, when we on the switch of voltmeter, electric circuit is completed. If we on the switch, electric circuit is completed. And what happens? There is deflection indicated by the voltmeter. First, it is on the zero, but after connecting, the circuit completed, and there is deviation or deflection is indicated by the voltmeter. And the circuit, now this circuit has two parts. One part is in the form of electrical wire, this, and another part is of this, that is the electrode and its solution. These two parts are there, and how the there is working between the two parts, let us see.